Hey, what is up, guys? This is Jerry here from Uncle Video Productions on the UVXC2000's channel. Today we have a special video because we are talking about WWDC 2017 as it is actually quickly approaching. It's going to be here any day now. So, before we begin, drop a like if you like the new studio. It is, kind of lit. I'm sorry, go ahead and unsubscribe. I'm a horrible person. Anyway, this is WWDC 2017, what we expect. A couple of oddballs here, actually. So, it'll be an interesting topic today. So, there are four guarantees in WWDC 2017 that we can absolutely count on. One is iOS 11. iOS 11 is kind of going to be a defining moment where it is really going to be the best operating system we've ever seen. iOS 10 was much needed and some redesign things. I know some people aren't necessarily full on board with iOS 10, with like music app and stuff, but other people, they love it. It was great, thank you for adding these new little roundish bubbles and stuff with the icons, but I definitely think iOS 11 will be really unique with things like the replacement of the wallet app to just built into the fingerprint sensor, adding Apple Pay through iMessage, which would be really huge because that's really going to take on some people like Venmo and other payment services. Group FaceTime calls is a must, as Skype has had their group messages and calls for a while. Honestly, I like Skype better than FaceTime. Sorry, Apple. So it is much needed. Also, what we're all hoping for is dark mode. Who wouldn't want dark mode? Smarter low power saving mode would be cool too. Some people predict that it will like know what location you're in, and if you always turn it on in that location, it will turn on by itself. Some people predict they will just have more controls over the low power mode. Honestly, I'm kind of in between where I do think it's going to get a lot better. I'm not sure it's going to be like full autonomous, like knowing your location, turning itself on. Don't think we're at that stage yet. And last is Siri. Huge improvements. With macOS 10.13 or macOS 11, it gets a little more complicated as there are so many few things like a more dark mode around the whole user interface and not whatever we have right now, as well as just more improvements in integration with iOS 11 and some in iOS 10 with messages not having all those effects and stuff, just as confetti. WatchOS 4, I honestly can't think of anything the WatchOS does. They completely reinvented WatchOS and WatchOS 3, but then they also added the Breathe app. And I feel like WatchOS 4 might be more of the Breathe app, because honestly, how many people use that? And then finally, tvOS 11, which will be kind of cool because we have a multi-account thing, which I'm hoping we see on iPads with iOS 11 as well. But we'll see where we go from there. Honestly, it seems like iOS 11 is where all the main features and all the main focuses, where the other operating systems is like, okay, we can make it better, but how better can we make it? Not that much. Another thing I hope to see in WWDC 2017 is a new Siri speaker. And this Siri speaker relies heavily on what's coming out in iOS 11. Now, I do think it will be unveiled, if it is, in WWDC 2017, but I definitely know for sure that it will not come out in June. Why? Here's why. Right now, Siri is very, very dumb compared to Alexa, Cortana, and Google Now. We're not going to count Bixby. If Siri came out now without its software update of iOS 11, it would be very bad and awkward too, because like, oh hey, you just bought the smart speaker back in June and now it's September and we have a major update that's going to change everything about your Siri smart speaker. What? No. Consumers wouldn't get that. See, I think it would have to come out after iOS 11 Siri does, if iOS 11 Siri does come with major improvements. They correspond with each other because I do think Siri will be a lot smarter than what she is on like macOS or the Apple Watch and the Apple TV. I think she has to heavily rely on this new code changes in iOS 11. There's also rumors that we will see a 10.5 inch iPad Pro. I don't know. Let me know what you think down below. What do you want to see in iOS 11 or any of the other software platforms? Or what do you want in the smart speaker? If you want to know a video about that, I will do one separately to talk more in depth about that. Let me know down below. Let me know about the new setup tour. Thanks for watching. I've been Jerry. Have a great day.